Megan and Setsu 3, or Secret of Mana 2, was never released outside of Japan. Square originally planned to release it, but another Super Nintendo game, Secret of Evermore, was brought over to North America instead. Other reasons for dropping Seiken and Setsu 3's international release involved the game itself, which apparently had bugs that they felt would disallow the game to be released in North America, and also the costs were pretty high. In 2000, a hacker named Neil Corlett released a fan translation of the game, and it was finally available to everyone outside of Japan, when video game ROMs and emulators started to become more and more popular. Although, thanks to Neil's translation and release, it has become well known as fans from the first Secret of Mana were eager to play it. And yes, the Game Light series is aimed at games that weren't really well known, but I'm making an exception for this one, as it was technically an import-only game. That, and it's one of my favorite RPGs of all time, so I wanted to make a video of it. In this world, the Mana Tree is dying and the Sanctuary is in great danger if something is not done. If the Mana Tree dies, then magic and mana will no longer exist in the world, and it would be at risk of being attacked by the Divine Beasts or an even greater power. You must take three characters and collect the spirits that represent each element. Wisp for light, Shade for darkness, Undini for water, Salamando for fire, Djinn for wind, Gnome for earth, Luna for moon, and Dryad for wood to obtain the Sword of Mana in order to prevent this disaster from happening. For some reason, I love the idea of collecting spirits for different elements. Tales of Phantasia did the same thing, and I quite liked that game as well. Not the Game Boy Advance one. My god, that was garbage. Don't ever play it. If anything, get the ROM or play a Japanese version of it. Seiken and Setsu 3 allows you to choose your main character from a selection of six possible characters, as well as two others that will form your main party for the entire game. Each story is different for each character, obviously, but they all converge at one town after you finish their prologue, and the game pretty much is the same for every character, save for a few special scenes. You have Duran, an orphan knight from the grassland kingdom of Forsenna, Kevin, a half-beast prince from Ferolia, or the Beast Kingdom, I think that's in the translation. Anyways, Hawk, a thief from the desert kingdom of Navarre, Angela, the princess of the magic kingdom Altena, Carly, a little girl from the holy city Wendell, and Lise, the princess and the captain of the Amazon army from the winged kingdom Rolant. In each of their prologues, something horrible happens to them, such as their best friend was killed, their mother plans to kill them, or everyone they ever loved was killed or stolen from them. They all recall the holy city Wendell being mentioned by some random person before they head out to seek help from the priest. You meet the rest of your team you selected along the way to Wendell, and like I mentioned before, after you all meet up, the story is pretty much the same, making the characters seem a bit boring and dull, but each of them holds a distinguishable personality. The gameplay is like the original and has a hack-and-slash type battle system that is enhanced by magic spells that you can either cast or use an item. You also have special moves that you can execute once you've landed a certain number of hits on the enemy. You will receive stronger finishing blows that differ depending on what class route you take. This is the chart for the class upgrades in this game. You have to be a certain level and access to a mana stone for the first level, and then the second level requires the same, but a higher level and a special item to unlock the class change. Classes also determine what magic you will obtain, if any. For example, Lise, if you choose her light route, she will obtain buffing magic. If you go for her dark route, she will learn debuffing magic. Leveling up to evolve into a better class is a real pain at times, as the game difficulty increases drastically and forces you to grind in order to upgrade to the next class. Getting the specific item to class change is also a pain, too. You have to fight certain enemies to obtain the question mark seed, then when you plant it, it will randomly generate an item, one that may or may not be useful. The dungeons can get a little long at times in parts of the game, but the music really makes up for it. This game has a beautiful soundtrack with songs that will stay with you for a long time. The final boss theme is one of the most epic things I've ever heard. It's so hype. Although this game doesn't have the most riveting story, nor are the characters really fleshed out much, it still works. There was no need for a deep story, weirdly complex characters, or a battle system on crack for it to be an enjoyable game. It has great music, fun boss fights, great visuals. It's simple yet fun. So go play it.
If you plan to play this game,
get Poto Oil. Black Market. No! Angela and Duran have the same main antagonist, and the second last dungeon. The same goes for Lise and Hawk, and Kevin and Carly. Enjoy!